How are you doing, everyone? And we will be looking at Masahiro Shimonuki's spectacular cut from an amazing episode in general, that being from 103. For context, if you are unaware who he is, Shimonuki made his first entry all the way back within episode 19 of the original Dragon Ball series, and has worked extensively on this show ever since, mostly as a key animator and animation supervisor. Moving on, Kazuya Hisada is the animation supervisor for this episode, with Yoshihiro Ueda being the director and storyboarder. And I was always a bit disappointed because I intended originally to talk about this particular cut way back within the Goku vs. Full Powered Freezer video, but it was something that sat outside of the main topic, so I'm quite excited to be able to discuss it at last. And like per usual, the featured artist is Bento underscore draws. This guy has some really solid work and is very skilled. He also does some Halo fan art, so that's an extra tick there. So go give his account a follow, you'll not be disappointed. And if you would like a chance at all to feature in a video, tag me on Instagram and use this hashtag. And now back to the video. So starting off with this cut, you have two groups of white and black speed lines representing the characters as they smash into multiple buildings with, like you would expect from Shimonuki, some great effects work with multiple pieces of rubble and some beautiful smoke plumes drawn with some stylish shapes. Both characters then appear with the key pose being held before being launched right into the ground with some more great smoke and rubble everywhere. And on the side, I really like Ueda's framing here of the rocks falling back onto the camera with a worm's eye perspective. Meanwhile, with the background spinning around, it's quite effective and attention grabbing. Then there is a flurry of kicks and punches with some rather nice exaggeration as Goku receives this kick to the head with some more beautiful character art of Frieza. I especially love how raw the artwork feels, in particular this frame with the chalk-like brush strokes and the multiple speed lines and the battle damage. It looks great and goes well with the tone of the scene. And moving on, there are some repeated frames and with some fairly good gestures as Frieza draws back his leg and it launches right into the viewer with about 4 frames of these extreme close-ups of his leg and several blank impact frames with the next shot following on with the first-person perspective, then with the same format again when he launches a punch. And it seems in the coloring stage there was this small little error with the nail here, but then after another snappy flurry you get a similar sequence again with all those intense close-ups. We then get some good anticipation as he prepares and launches into this kick, although the upper body is somewhat stiff, but it doesn't overly detract from the motion, with a smooth zoom into Goku, who appears to be off guard before suddenly dodging and grabbing Frieza's leg. The close-ups on Goku we just saw were great, but this one in particular of Frieza is excellent, with some very thick lines and black shading around the creases of the face, which work perfectly in adding to that intense look. Then right after, Shimonuki delivers more exaggerated and dramatic expressions that really sell the pain, with some more stretched out necks and flowy hair with this nice kick which plants Goku right through this building, with Shimonuki again meticulously drawing all these little rocks. His detailed effects work really just adds some depth. Then we get an interesting perspective as they battle inside this building, snapping between a series of blows. Frieza then thereafter draws back his punch with a nicely drawn pose with expressive character art and some bold line work for the hand, with his fist then completely covering the camera with these tight close-ups, and there being a small pause as Goku sways to the side, building up that anticipation right before he goes in for the punch himself with a similar sequence of timing. The punch is executed beautifully with the snapping between these poses, with thereafter my favorite part as Frieza is knocked back through the wall, and the sequence in which the glass and wall breaks apart is so satisfying in how it's executed with the immense amount of detailed effects and the timing. It's just spectacular. Frieza then flies back with all the rubble following in suit before a series of forceful gestures, and combined with the framing with all like the dust clouds and rocks, it's incredibly impactful. And with this punch launched at Goku, we are treated with that chalky brush again with some really bold speed lines before Goku dodges out of the way, launching into this devastating kick. I love the flow to the gesture here, as well as how buff he draws both these characters. And as is the trend in this fight, Frieza is launched into another building with all those great effects once again, with Shimonuki delivering some more dramatic close-ups of Frieza with that wide open mouth, bold mouth creases, the squinted eye, blood around the mouth and above his eyebrow, and finally all the multiple scratches that go so well in selling his anger and this progression in his frustration. But Frieza returns with this smoothly animated flick of the tail with more gorgeous character art before Goku vanishes behind with some rather nice poses leading into this karate chop to the back of the neck with a simple impact frame and those exaggerated and wide open mouths that are all over this cut as we have seen. Goku pursues after him before Frieza quickly zips dipped to the side, launching off a rock with a beautiful impact frame and some nice aura effects. And when Frieza is struck, he holds the key pose and adds all that camera shake before Frieza flicks around and kicks Goku back. And I like Shimonuki's small addition in animating Goku brushing up against a tree before crashing with more rubble and dust clouds erupting, with some really nice lava effects painted with some rather different colors that eventually cover the camera, ending his cut there. Overall, the placement of the key animators in regards to their assigned cuts may have been somewhat odd within this episode, such as regulating Naoki Tate to mostly dialogue scenes, with exception to that odd rotation near the end of Takauchi's cut, which was nice, but Ueda made the perfect choice in placing Shimonuki here, and he 100% nails the storyboard with impactful delivery to blows, highly detailed keyframes with expressive character art, beautiful effects work like you would expect, and some nice timing. And although this video isn't about Ueda, his storyboard for this portion was excellent. He built up an intense atmosphere with like the black and red clouds in the background. He also made good use of environments in this battle, from the two characters fighting in the air to inside of the buildings and smashing each other through buildings, trees and cliffs, which made it quite interesting. A really engaging scene and episode in general, but anyway, I'll end it there. Thanks as always for watching, hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you later.